Hello, good evening.
Good evening, teacher.
I was showing some, presenting some issues with the internet, and that's why I couldn't connect exactly at 8. Sorry for the 3 minutes late, but we're here now. So, how are you people? Let's see who is connected. Maritza, Carla, Ruth, and Eric. So how are you? How was your day, people?
I'm fine, teacher, and you?
You're fine, really? That's nice to hear. Here, good, fine too. It was like a long day, but it was good. It was good. So how do you feel now? Maritza?
Very good, teacher.
Very good, really?
I'm stable.
Okay. No, but that's great. That's great to hear. It means that you didn't you haven't suffered any kind of like problem with your health and anything like that, right? That's excellent. Why don't you turn on your cameras? Sí.
He tenido.
Ajá.
Okay.
Good evening.
Good evening, Eric. Ajá. Maritza.
Síntomas así bien leves, pero ayer sí me molestó bastante el dolor de garganta y cabeza. Hoy también, pero estable.
Ajá. Well, okay. That's great. That's really cool then. Yeah, it means that you're getting better every day. That is awesome. So let's see. Good, Eddie. Good. Good. I did it with mine already.
¿Qué es, teacher? Vamos a ver.
¿Ah?
¿Qué es esto?
Tu estaca. Tu estaca.
Cabal.
San Miguel.
Tu estaca, San Michael City.
Really nice, right? Oh,
super delicious. A mí siempre me ha gustado.
Really?
Cuando yo iba a Oriente, antes me iba a Chinameca.
Mm-hmm.
Allá. A comprar totopostes.
Esos totopostes de ahí sí son calidad, mire, los de Chinameca.
Chinameca. A comprar totopostes y tus tacas traía $5 de cada cosa.
Wow.
Really?
Sí. Really? Sí, le traía a mi mamá, a mi tía, y traía para mí.
Ajá.
Es que cuando puedo, cuando yo sé que alguien va para allá, le encargo.
Uh-huh. Yeah, I mean that one. Those type of things in here are very, very common. You can find them everywhere, even in Usulutan. There are places that sell those things.
En La Unión, is the same case, and the. In the park and in the mercado, ¿cómo? En el mercado.
The market.
Son las grandes guacaladas así de totoposte. Como 25 a 30 totoposte le ponen por el dólar.
Yeah, I mean, that's true. That's true.
No hay miseria.
Claro que no. Claro
sí, pero
que no.
El mejor es el de Chinameca.
A mí me gusta bastante.
Do you think it's better? ¿Usted cree que son mejores?
Sí. La consistencia, la masita es diferente a los de los otros.
Yeah, I mean,
llevan más grasa.
Yeah, that's true. That one is true. Ajá. Ajá. Yes. So that was good, Eric. So you are eating those ones from here, from Oriente. That's nice. I have like 2 weeks without buying. Yeah, like 2 weeks that I haven't bought Yeah, but they are like really delicious. My grandma likes those type of things, and my mother too. They really love those things. All right, let's see. More and more getting connected, so I'm prepared. I'm here, the attendance list. Just give me a second. I'm just gonna put this. My God. Okay. So I'm gonna pass the attendance list because we got a lot of things to do today, people. We're gonna continue talking about the topic that we were discussing yesterday. If you remember, there were like two different topics at the same time. It was the uses of be in simple past and also the use of simple past with positive statements. We are gonna do the opposite today. If yesterday we were practicing positive statements, today we will be practicing negative statements. So that's gonna be like pretty similar to what we were discussing yesterday, but you know, in a different context. So let's start with the attendance list. Let's see, we got Ana Claribel. It is not here, right? Ana Maria. All right, they usually come late. Carlos Ademir. Okay, no. Eric Guillermo.
Present.
All right, got it here. Ever de Jesus.
Present, teacher.
Okay, good. Fatima Alejandra. It's because it's Friday, right? Most of these people are buying things or having fun or whatever they are. Let's see. Hilmar Cruz.
Present.
And hey, that's a miracle that Hilmar came on time before the attendance list. What happened, Hilmar? I mean, today is Friday, Hilmar. I thought you were connecting late, but actually it was early. That's nice.
It's something, the rain.
Yeah, that's why it's raining.
La más usada en el grupo.
Exactly, exactly. Jonathan Alexander.
Yo lo limpié a ver.
Jonathan, are you there?
Present.
Ah, okay, good. Jorge Elder.
Present.
All right, perfect. Carla Benacer.
Present, teacher.
Okay, good. Margot Fernandez. Ah, yeah, she's there. Margot, are you there? Okay, I think she's not there. All right. Let's see, Maritza Alcira.
Present, teacher.
Ah, okay, very good. Then we got Natalie Vanessa, she's not here yet. Romeo Alexis. Okay, don't have it here yet. Rosa del Carmen.
Present.
Ah, okay. Good. Ruth Joanna.
Present, teacher.
Ah, okay. Good. There you go. We got it here. Sarah Carolina. Nah, I mean, Sarah starts working. Today is, I mean, it's Friday. She has to work more than normal. Okay, let's see. Stephanie Lissette is not here. Vanessa Odette. She's not here yet. And William Alberto. No, William is not connected yet. Let me check. Roxana Yesenia. I mean, that's weird. These people are not connected. Nubia Zulema. That's really weird on Nubia. Jennifer Noemi. And Diana Gabriela.
Present, teacher.
Ah, okay.
Present, teacher.
Okay. That's a double question.
La oyó, la oyó.
Sí, sí.
Ya, ya.
Okay, okay. Ah, present, present. Ya va a ser extraño no escucharla cuando tal vez no esté ahí.
Pero es igual que Jennifer, a media clase se duerme y ya al final ya no responde.
Hey, that's true, that's true. Hey, Jennifer, no se ha conectado ya. No, I mean, I had to take her out yesterday because she was there, I mean, and she didn't answer. That was so funny. Just give me a second. I'm opening this file and it doesn't open and I don't know why. My God, this computer sometimes got crazy. All right, let me check. I'm gonna put it in here.
The computer.
Yes, let me check. The thing is that I got the file, but apparently, no, just take a look at this. My God, I got the file, but apparently something happened to the file. Give me a second. There you go. Apparently something happened to the file and the program kicked me out of it. So when I was trying to enter again, it says that it was with a problem. Apparently, probably it's a virus or something like that. That sometimes locked me down from using some of the applications that I got here, some of the programs. No, but it is working now, all right? So let's start off with this. So let's remember, this is the video conference number 12, and today's topic is how to use passive P and simple past negative, okay? What does it mean? If you remember yesterday class, the topic was simple past of be and simple past affirmative statements. What does it mean? That yesterday, basically, we were just talking about positive statements only, using was and were, and using the past of some very, very common verbs. Now we're gonna do the opposite. We're gonna do it, but in negative statements. That's pretty much what we have for tonight. But let's start with the things that we got from yesterday. What do we remember exactly from yesterday, people? What do we remember from yesterday? Since we know that we were practicing the simple past of the verb be and the simple past of regular verbs and irregular verbs, of course. What do you remember from it? Like, for example, when we talk about the verb be, what are the two forms of the verb be in simple past?
Teacher, I remember the use of the was with I, he, she, it, singular. I don't know.
Singular nouns.
Okay. Exactly.
Yeah, let's remember when we talk about singular nouns, it's just one proper noun. It can be about an animal, right? It can be about a person, or it can be about a place. Okay. Animal,
you person, swear.
Place. Carla.
And they use to was and where?
Jorge was saying that we use was for he, she, it, and singular nouns. When do we use where, Carla? Or with what pronouns do we use where?
We use to you, we, they, and the plural nouns.
Okay, we use it with you, we, they, okay, and plural nouns. What does it mean when we mention two or more people, right? Two or more pets, two or more places. Hi, Rosanna, welcome. All right, so in that case, we use where. So I can say, I was in the class last night. I was in the class last night. Okay. You were in the office today. Okay. Ustedes estaban en la oficina este día. So you see, those actions are in the past. Okay. So that way we use was and were. Okay. What other examples can you provide by using where in affirmative statements? Example, Eddie, give me one example, whether using was or were. Let's see if you remember. Tomando en cuenta de que cuando usamos el verbo to be, ya sea was or were, no usamos un verbo adicional. ¿Por qué? Porque was y were son los verbos que funcionan, ok, como verbo principal en este caso. ¿Qué necesitamos en ese caso? Podemos necesitar nombres, como por ejemplo, the name teacher, a noun teacher, an architect, something like that, referring to professional occupations, or when we describe a place where we are in that exact moment. For example, you are in your house, you were in your work. So we're mentioning a place in that case, right? Entonces ahí lo que podemos usar también son adjetivos. Cuando describimos ya sea un estado emocional o a una persona, right? Example. Exactly, like
he was happy yesterday.
There you go, exactly. You're describing an emotional state. There you go. Eric, give me an example.
I was in a meeting today morning.
Okay, very good. I was in a meeting today morning. There you go. So that's a past activity, right? That you started in the past and finished in the past. Very good. Maritza, give me one example.
She was bored.
She was bored. Bored. Okay.
Bored.
Okay. There you go. Thank you, Maritza. Ever, can you give me one example? Ever?
For was.
You can even use you can use was or where, depending on what you want to talk about.
Okay, I was very busy at noon.
Busy at noon.
Busy.
Ah, okay. There you go. You were very busy at noon. Okay, very good. Hilmar, give me one example.
The was.
Using was or where, whatever you want.
Vamos a ver. I was a good student.
Okay.
La sinceridad de todo.
I was a, okay. Listen. I was a good student. It means that right now he is not a good student.
Hoy soy mejor.
okay. No, you might say, now I am not a good student. I am a better student.
Better.
Even better than before, right?
Yo pensé que le iba a decir, I was up todo el día.
I was up. No, but you can say that, Eric. I was up during the day. But was up from be awakened, de estar despierto. You can't even do that. Pero no was up, I mean the one that you text, right? Nothing related to that. All right. Jonathan, give me one example.
I was day very hard.
Okay, it was a very hard day. Fue un día bien difícil. It was. Cuando se refiere a días, cuando ustedes van a describir un día, si ha sido sencillo, si ha sido difícil, vamos a comenzar con it, porque el it es para referirse a objetos o algo inanimado, pero como en este caso, hablaríamos de un día en específico y no de nosotros, entonces usaríamos it. It was a hard day, como fue un día difícil. All right. Okay, Jonathan. Thank you, Jonathan. Jorge, give me one example, Jorge.
Yes. I was prepared coffee. In that case,
because prepare is a verb, Jorge, it is not possible. Porque en ese caso, en ese caso sería, I was preparing. Entonces ya la oración se convierte en pas. Exactly. Y ahí ya se convierte en otra estructura.
Okay. Okay. Thank you for the declaration.
Nah, okay. Yeah, I mean, in that case, that's why we don't have to write down or we don't have to say an extra verb. Y ahí, como ese es un extra verbo, that's why it is not possible. Because okay. in that case, the sentence becoming past progressive.
Oh.
Yes.
Okay, it change the question, the answer is?
Yes, en ese caso, tendríamos que cambiar, we got to change the verb. I mean, don't mention the verb.
Okay.
All right. Perfect. Yeah, in that case, we don't get to mention the verb. All right, there you go.
Okay.
Carla, give me one example on your own. It can be about first person, talking about you, or using a third person, or even a plural, if you want.
I was in the mall last night.
I was in the mall last night. Okay, very good. Thank you. Okay, nice. Thank you. William?
You're welcome.
Give me one example, William, whether using was or were.
Okay. The movie were interesting.
In that case, if you're talking about only one movie, so then it was. The movie was.
It was. The movie was.
Uh-huh.
Interesting.
Okay, very good. The movie was interesting. In that case, it's correct. Thank you, William. Let me check who else. Rosa, are you there? Give me one example, Rosa. Rosa, are you there?
Hi. Today I was a long day.
It was a long day. Es algo similar a la que mencionó Jonathan, okay? When we talk about an specific day.
Estaba dudando por eso.
All right. Yeah, in that case, when we talk about a specific day, let's remember, we can use it with it. It was. Fue. Okay, thank you, Rosa. Now, Diana, give me one example, Diana.
Teacher, yo no sé si he comprendido bien, pero lo voy a decir. Es que ayer casi no estuve en la clase. Vaya, sería the sky was clear.
Ah, okay, very good. Yeah.
Así es. Entonces, es como que es que no he entendido muy bien, fíjese. Porque como le repito, ayer casi no me conecté tarde, medio he entendido.
Ah, okay. Ya, yeah, pero es la clase.
Pero what significa que es el futuro.
No, es pasado.
¿Cómo?
Pasado, perdón. Yes. Es la forma, was and were son las dos formas pasadas del verbo to be.
Ah, okay.
En presente simple solemos utilizar am, is, and are. Entonces en pasado simplemente es was and were.
Ah, perfecto. Gracias, teacher.
Ah, ok. You're welcome. Ajá. Y la otra estudiante ahí practicando atrás. That was funny.
Sí, ahí está.
Yeah, I can listen to her. All right. Let me see. Who else is in here? Ah, Fátima. Ah. Just to come late, Fátima, give me one example. Using was.
Había mucho tráfico, teacher.
Ajá, tráfico.
Okay, teacher present.
Exactly.
¿Qué dijo? No escuché.
Ah, es de las más usadas, dice.
Ah. No, sí había demasiado tráfico.
Yeah, vaya. Yes.
La vieja confiable.
My example is she was in the university the last year.
Ah, okay, very good. There you go. Thank you, Fatima. Okay. Let's see who else show up late. Ah, Nubia. Let's give me one example. I mean, that's Nubia is another one that is connecting at this time. Ah, too much traffic, Nubia.
Yes.
same excuse as Fatima.
Another one.
Yes.
All right, no, teacher, right. Me cogió el tiempo, mucho tráfico.
Yes, I know.
Espéreme que yo ayer la hice, pero bueno, era con was, ¿verdad? En primera y tercera persona.
Exactly. Uh-huh. Was and where.
Sí. Con was, Andrea was in university. Last week.
Ah, okay. Andrea was in the university last week. Okay, very good. Thank you, Nubia.
Okay.
That was a very good example. Let me see who else is in here. The one who showed up yesterday. Romeo. Let's give me one example, Romeo. Yeah, you were in the class yesterday.
Okay. She was very punchable.
She was
very punchable.
Punctual. She was very punctual. Ah, okay. All right. Thank you, Romeo. Let me see who else besides Romeo. Ah, Roxana. Yeah, Roxana was in the class yesterday. All right, Roxana, give me one example from the structures that we were practicing yesterday.
Ahorita, teacher.
Okay.
He was, la callan. Sería he was. Ay, teacher, no me acuerdo, lo escribí ayer, pero no me acuerdo. He was studying in the university.
Let's remember, Roxana, en este caso no vamos a usar un verbo extra. Entonces, el verbo study no puede ir. Solo tiene que ir el verbo was. Okay, en este caso, forma el verbo to be.
Sería, he was secretary.
Ok. He was a secretary. Él era una secretaria. Okay.
Hoy los géneros no importa.
That's what I'm thinking. Yeah, I mean, I'm not here to discriminate anything. All right. If you say that, Rosanna, then it's okay. All right.
Then it's okay.
Don't get me wrong, Jorge.
Okay. Sorry.
All right. Okay. Yeah, I mean, another example can be Roxana. For example, he was in the park last night. Right? That's another one. All right? So we're mentioning a very specific place. Okay. Good. Let me see. Just one person is missing. Ruth, give me one example. Yeah, Ruth is missing.
Yes, teacher. All right. You were pulling yesterday.
You were?
Pulled yesterday.
You were full?
Pool. Piscina?
Ah, you were in the pool.
Ah, okay. You were in pool yesterday.
Ah, okay. Very good.
El otro es I was secretary in church.
Okay, all right. Thank you, Ruth. There you go.
Okay.
Cool. Now, Now that we got that short examples from the things that we were practicing yesterday, that structure using was and were, now let's continue. So the main points that we're gonna have for the class is like the review from the previous class, something that we had just said right now, okay? Give me a second. There you go. Okay, we got the review, something that we just did right now. Then we're gonna start up with the simple past of be and simple past, the structure, you know, in negative statements, both of them, the verb be and the simple past of the verbs. Then we're gonna provide some examples. You're gonna give some examples to me too. Then we're gonna do some exercises in the manual, okay? We got a conversation in the manual. And then of course, we're gonna check those exercises, right? In the manual. That's pretty much what we have for tonight, okay? Good. Simple past of be negative statements. What do we generally need? Listen, what do we generally need to create sentences? Listen, to create sentences in simple past negative statement. That's really, really, really easy. We just write down not between the verb be and the complement. That's it. That's the way how we create negative statement, by putting not right after the verb be. And that's it. How come? Check this out. If I write down in here, check this out. If I write down in here, check this out. Affirmative. I was an excellent student. This is an affirmative statement. What do we do to make this affirmative statement into a negative statement?
I wasn't an excellent student.
There you go. Thank you, Miss. Check this out. I, okay, we got the subject, okay, and we got was. Let's start this way. Check this out. I was not an excellent
student.
What does it mean? This is a very formal way to make this sentence negative. Now, this is an informal way to make it. Check this out. I, and we get contracted, was plus not. And we check this out, wasn't. Let me check. As Maritza was saying, I wasn't an excellent student. Check this out. What do we got here? Now in here, we got two ways in which we can create negative statements using the verb be. Okay, this is just first person, okay? Just first person. What happened with the second person? It's pretty similar to this one, okay? Check this out. Affirmative. I'm just making a comparison, okay? You were, check this out, you were on time to work, okay? You were on time to work, right? Estaba o estuviste a tiempo, okay? O estuviste a la hora en el trabajo, right? Negative statement.
You were not.
Exactly, right? Check this out. You were You were not on time to work. What is the only thing I am putting in there? Use the word not to make it negative. And where is placed the word not? After the verb be. Right after the verb be. All the time is right after the verb be. Okay. And check this out, the informal way or the contracted way. All right. And we can say you weren't. There you go. You weren't on time to work. All right. So we got affirmative statement. Okay, the one in positive, the ones that we were practicing yesterday. Now we got the negative statement. This negative statement is formal, is a formal way to do it. Okay. Now this negative statement with a contraction form, this is the informal way to create negative statements. Okay. This is an informal way. That is the difference. Okay. With one, the one that is contracted, we use it the most when we speak. Okay, when you talk, you use the most contractions, okay? But informal documents, when you write down formal documents, you have to use the formal way, okay? And what is it? The one that is not contracted. Okay, this is just for a second person. What happened in a third person form? When we use was, all right, let's remember, we use was with he, she, it, or singular nouns, okay? Let's put it in here. Was is used with he, she, it, and singular nouns, remember. And when we talk about singular nouns, remember, we are talking about very specific nouns, okay? For example, we can say Carla, Jorge, right? I must say, okay, this is just an example. You see, these ones are singular nouns, okay? Or we can even include animals like pets. The dog, the cat, all right? The, which one?
They, the day.
Nah, okay, including exactly the day. There you go. In that case, we use, check this out, we use was. Okay, give me a second, I'm gonna make this bigger so it can fit this way. There you go. Okay, so we can write that example, all right? We can write down examples. Just let's do a couple of them. Example, he, in affirmative statements, in affirmative statement, he was in the park. Where? Let's put in the park right now. He was in the park last night. Okay. Now, the negative statement.
He wasn't.
Okay, the negative statement, the formal way.
He was not
in the park last night. Okay, and the negative statement, the contracted form. This is the contraction form. He wasn't. Okay, he wasn't in the park last night. Okay, and we can continue with those series of examples, right? And the verb won't change. The verb won't change. For example, check this out. I can say, Affirmative. The dog was in the yard. Okay, the negative statement. Let's put it in an informal way. The dog wasn't in the yard. You see, what are we doing in that case? We are putting, okay, a pet name, but in singular. When we talk about the dog, it's only one animal, right? Only one dog. That's why we write down was. If I say in that case, if I say the dogs, the plural version, so then it's not was. It has to be were. Let's remember, okay? The dogs were in the yard. Now, in that case, we're mentioning more than one, probably two, three, etc. Dogs, okay? So check this out. Right up to now, with these examples, do you have any question related to this structure? At least the one that we got in here, the examples that we got in here. Is it clear for you, or do we have any question? Because if you have any question, please let me know. Let me know right now. Everything is okay?
It's clear.
Okay, there you go. If it is clear, so then we can continue. I don't know if you're taking notes about those examples, or may I continue? ¿Están tomando nota de los ejemplos o puedo continuar? Let me know.
Estamos tomando nota.
Nah, okay. There you go. Let me know when you finish so I can move on.
I'm done.
Okay, good, Jorge. Okay. What's up with the rest? Ah, okay, good. Ah, thank you, Eric. You sent the screenshot to the group. That's even better. Okay, let's keep going. I need to erase this part. Okay, good. So what do we got here? Just a structure, okay? The one that we already know. In the structure, let's remember, grammatically speaking, it goes the subject. Let's remember that the subject can be any pronoun or proper noun, okay? Any pronoun or proper noun. And which ones are the pronouns? I, you, he, she, it, we, you, they. And proper noun, like a real noun, a name from a person, a place, or pets, animals, whatever you call them, right? And then the form of the verb be, okay? Be, let's remember, it can be was or it can be were, okay? Then we got not. And then the complement. And the complement has to be according to the subject and what you want to, you know, like to produce. Okay, there you go. So we got the examples here, right? I was not very happy. Okay, so I was not very happy. Let's see, Roxana, help me reading.
I was not very happy.
The second example, Roxana.
You were not interested in action movie.
Action movies. Okay, thank you, Roxana. You were not interested in action movies, right? Or you weren't interested in action movies. We can contract were plus not. Let's remember and create only one word. Carla, help me out reading this one.
You were not, oh, no, no, no. He was not a teacher.
Nah, okay. Yeah, I mean, so you can even tell me you were not a teacher a few years ago. You were a student, right? Okay, thank you, Carla. Then we got the next example, and let's give the welcome to Vanessa. Let's read.
Okay, so she was not a lawyer.
Okay, thank you. She was not a lawyer, right? So in that case, we got the combination between plus, I mean, was plus not. Okay, oh, we can even write down wasn't, right? She wasn't a lawyer. There you go. We need a noun in there. Okay. I think that's the last one. I got the last one here. Ever, help me reading the last one.
They were not in Mexico. Mexico.
Yeah, Mexico, because Mexico, that's Spanish, right? That's Spanish. All right, there you go. What is the contracted form, Fátima? ¿Cuál es la forma contractada de esa oración, Fátima? ¿Podría mencionármela, por favor? Can you read it for me?
They weren't in Mexico.
In Mexico, okay.
Se quiere decir México.
That was funny. All right, thank you, Fátima. That's correct, right? They weren't, okay, in Mexico. There you go. Thank you. Now, to see if you have understood this topic, I want you to recreate one example. Let's make it up. One example, listen up. It can be on third person or first person and one in plural, okay? I want to see how well you are with this structure, okay? You can put it contracted or you can put it separated, okay? It's up to you. But I want one example using was and one example using were, okay? So in total, you gotta do two examples, right? I will give you 1 minute for you to write down the example and then read it to me. When you finish, turn on the microphone and tell me, teacher, I finished, and I start reading the example, okay? Let's write it down. Write two examples, one using was and the other one using were. Were you about to say something, Jonathan?
No, perdón, de copiar.
I didn't listen that much, Jonathan. No le escuché muy bien.
No, no terminé de copiarle.
Okay, all right. Let's finish copying and then do the examples.
Teacher, sorry, no sé si solo yo, pero casi no le escuché lo que las indicaciones. Le escuché cortado.
Really?
Okay. No sé si solo soy yo o fue mi internet o si todos, pero yo no le entendí, solo le entendí dos, was, were, no entendí más. Sí.
Okay, let's see. ¿Los demás me escucharon perfectamente o también me escucharon como Eric? Perfectly. Ya le está haciendo efecto, Eric.
Algo cortado se escuchó.
En sí, cafés.
Vaya, ya ve, no me está echando la culpa a mí, ya va,
fue un grupo, fue un grupo entonces, se fue en grupo.
No soy yo el que me las he echado ahorita.
Porque Ever le hizo así, ve, like, excellent. No, listen.
No, le digo que ya llevaba tres,
No, listen, in that case, what I'm asking is basically you to write down two examples. One example using was, you can do it personally or you can use a third person, okay? Or you have to use was in one example and use were in the second example, representing a plural, okay? And when you finish, all right, just turn on the microphone and tell me, teacher, I finished, and read the two examples.
I finished, teacher.
There you go, Nubia. You can read the examples if you want.
Okay, the one example is Andrea was not concert in the National Theater.
Andrea was?
Not concert.
Andrea was not in the concert. Andrea no estaba en el concierto.
Ah, okay.
That's what you mean? Mm-hmm. Ah, okay. In the concert. Ajá.
Okay. Y la otra sería Andrea y Rodrigo were not in the park.
Nubia, let's repeat that example, please.
Andrea and Rodrigo were not in the party.
Okay. Es que en la primera opción me dijo Andrea y Rodrigo, and I was like, what? Is she using
Spanish? No, perdón. La primera era Andrea, la segunda. Andrea y Rodrigo.
No, I mean, what I'm saying is that you said Andrea y Rodrigo. So what's up? That's Spanglish. Y
Rodrigo. Ah, okay.
And.
Yes, Andrea and Rodrigo.
Okay.
Yes.
Very good. There you go.
Pero así está bien. We're not in the party.
Exactly. Okay. It is correct because you're talking about two people. Very good. Anyone else that has
finished?
All right, Rosa, go on.
She was not present in the class.
Yes.
And you were not a good friend.
Now I am a good friend, but back in the day, nah, I was not a good friend, Rosa. There you go.
Finish, teacher.
Okay, go on, Carla.
Yeah, I was not in the party on time.
Ah, okay. Let's change it a little bit. I was not on time in the party.
On time, okay.
Yeah, I was not on time in the party, or to the party in this case. All right, just give me a second, Hilmar. Carla is missing one example, right? Right after she finished, it goes you.
It was not.
I didn't listen to the second example, Carla. All right, I think the internet is not
in the school.
Not in the school. But I didn't listen to the rest.
Yo no entiendo mucho porque como que se queda frisado.
Yes. Igual, que se me quedó así como que. No, but let's read. Once again.
You were not in the school.
Okay, very good. You were not in the school. Thank you, Carla. Good. Now, listen, people. Para los que no han hecho la actualización de Zoom, ya hay una nueva actualización de Zoom para los que especialmente usan computadora. Entonces, a veces si hay fallas y no es el internet, y no es mi internet ni el suyo, probablemente puede hacer la aplicación que a veces, porque no está up to date, puede estar fallando. Okay. Just for future, you know, like conferences. All right, Hilmar, go on.
Okay. He was not an active student.
Okay.
And number two, they were not participatory in the class.
They were not participatory. Okay, all right. I'll buy that one. All right. That is acting like an adjective. Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because participating, that would be like the verb, and that turns into past progressive. All right. But you're not using the verb. All right. Thank you, Hilmar. Who else is finished? Okay, Maritza, do it.
She and I were not the best friend.
She and I were not the best friends. Okay, good.
And he wasn't a businessman.
Ah, okay. He wasn't a businessman. Okay. Very good. Thank you, Maritza. Who else has finished?
You're the
No, okay, who said me? First Jonathan and then Jorge. Okay, Jonathan.
Okay. I was not hungry yesterday.
I was not hungry.
I was not hungry yesterday.
Ah, pero cuando usamos la palabra homework, Jonathan, a pesar de que sea un nombre, necesitamos un verbo, que en este caso sería el verbo do. Por lo tanto, en la oración ya se convertiría en pasado progresivo, porque tendría que decir, I was not doing the homework yesterday, because we got the word hungry. En este caso, sí, esa, la palabra homework, tendríamos que cambiarla, Jonathan. Okay, and write down an adjective. All right.
I was happy.
Okay, all right. But the negative version.
I was not happy yesterday.
Ah, okay, very good. That's different, right? I was not happy yesterday. It means that today probably you're happy. And the second example?
They were not English class.
Okay, good. They were not in this class. Thank you, Jonathan. All right, Jorge.
Okay. They were not in front of the supermarket.
Okay, very good.
And another one, I was not in the museum. Museum.
Yeah, that's the word.
Okay.
Museum. Okay, very good. Thank you.
Teacher.
Uh-huh.
I was not happy about the news.
Very good.
And you were not pay attention to the class.
Technically, it's correct. But that's past progressive because you're saying you were not paying attention. Pay is a verb.
Ah, sí, sí.
Yes, you need to
write
that one. So, la forma del verbo to be lo está obligando a que el verbo pay vaya con ing, paying. So, let's change that one, Ever, right? And let me know when you finish. That one. Okay, who else has finished? ¿Quién más terminó ya?
Yo, teacher. Okay.
First, Roxana, then Ruth, and then Fátima, okay?
Yeah, teacher. Mis ejemplos, I was not an employer that super selecto.
Okay, I was not an employer from super selecto. Uh-huh.
They were not payasos.
Clowns. Clowns. I'm gonna write it down. Okay, I will send the word to you. Give me a second. Clowns is like this. Like this. Okay, I already sent it to you, Roxana, throughout the chat. Clowns.
Hello. Okay. Clowns.
There you go. Ruth, give me your examples.
Yes, teacher. I was not at the movies.
Okay, good.
You was not yesterday in home.
En vez de was, en ese de you, es were. You were not.
Ay, cierto.
Yes.
You were not yesterday in home.
En ese caso sería, you were not at home yesterday.
Oh, okay.
Yes, primero se menciona at home, en casa, y luego al final la time expression, que en este caso sería yesterday, la expresión de tiempo. Okay, good, Ruth. Thank you. Just modify that one, right? Fátima, let's read your example.
He was not bad boy.
He was not a bad boy. Okay, huh? That's why I fell in love with him.
And they were not in the restaurant.
Okay, they were not in the restaurant. Okay, very good. Thank you, Fatima. Eric.
Okay, teacher. I'm fine with my perrita.
With your
estoy, female, estoy peleando con mi perrita que me está mordiendo por ahí.
You're okay. Fighting with your little dog? What happened to it? Probably she's hungry.
No, inquieta está, mira. Está inquieta. Una, es una mini. Una.
Estamos tiernos.
Tiene mes, no, 2 meses tiene. 2 meses, pero es ¿qué raza? Me
olvidé. What breed is
Chihuahua.
That?
Chihuahua.
What breed is that? Ah, that's a Chihuahua.
Pero yeah. Está inquieta, está mordiendo.
Really?
Really.
Yeah. Son interactivos.
Sí. They are cute. They are cute. My wife loves those type of dogs, but when you grab them, it feels like you're shaking like that. Como que es teléfono vibrando. They are funny. They are funny. Todo el tiempo andan temblando. That's funny. All right.
Okay. I wasn't in the beach last week.
Okay, good.
And second, they weren't in the office yesterday.
All right, they weren't in the office yesterday. Okay, thank you, Eric. There you go. Let me see who else has finished. Vanessa, do you finish your examples? All right, go on.
Yes, teacher. Okay. Number one, she was not a good doctor.
Okay, good.
Okay. They were not traveling.
In this case, el verbo, sea cual sea, Vanessa, tenemos que eliminarlo porque entonces ya nos estaríamos cambiando de estructura. Ya no sería pasado simple con be, ya sería pasado progresivo porque llevamos un verbo adicional. En ese caso, lo que podemos hacer ahí es colocar un adjetivo que describa a esa persona, ¿ok? O mencionar un lugar donde esa persona pudo estar. All right.
They were not traveling in Panama.
En vez de travel, puede decir, they were not in Panama. Y eliminamos, okay. Y eliminamos el verbo travel. And that in that example will be correct, right? They were not in Panama. All right, thank you, Vanessa. Romeo, do you finish?
You were not interested in the game.
Interested in the game.
Okay,
good.
I was not today in the house.
I was not in the house today. Recordemos la time expression al final, Romeo. Okay? Good. Thank you. Let me see who else is missing. William, do you finish?
Okay. The first, I wasn't picnic.
Okay, or I wasn't in the picnic. Okay, good.
And he wasn't happy with she.
En este caso, en vez de she, pondríamos her.
Okay.
Her. Yes, okay. Es como quien recibe la acción. En este caso, el object pronoun. Se lo voy a escribir en el chat. Her. Ajá. Okay, there you go. Thank you, William. Let me check. Who else is missing? Let me see. Vanessa has participated. Jonathan has already participated. Yana. Let me see. I am Diana. Did you participate already, Diana? I haven't listened to you.
No, no he participado.
Okay, go on.
Allison. He was not a special person.
Ah, okay, he was not a special person. Interesting.
Okay.
And the solo second answer? They were two, Diana. They were two. Let's do one using where.
Okay, entonces podría ser I was
usando where, using where.
Where. Quiero ver. Ay, déjame pensar. Okay. La voy a hacer bien, la voy a estructurar bien. Ya se la digo.
Okay, all right. There you go. Despite your like almost entering, Mrs. Urrutia, I don't know if you did them. Can you give me an example using a negative statement with was and were?
Pues, la verdad es que no los he hecho, teacher, pero voy a intentar.
Ajá.
Vale. Yeah.
Okay.
Una sería, I was in park yesterday.
In the park yesterday.
In the park yesterday.
Okay.
And they weren't.
Huh?
They weren't. They weren't happy, very happy.
Okay. They weren't. I don't know why do I feel that. No tengo una así como. Come on, Stephanie. you're ready from there. La tomó de ahí. No, hombre.
Ay, es que no, no.
Cheater. Okay, all right. But that is okay. It's okay. Ana María, how about you? Ana María, hoy ni enciende la cámara ni el micrófono. What's up, Ana María?
Lea su correo, su WhatsApp, lo puede leer. Es que estoy en una reunión de trabajo y entonces lo estoy oyendo a usted y medio estoy oyendo lo que ustedes dicen y estoy en la otra reunión. Entonces, no sé, hasta ganas de salirme ya de la clase, ¿verdad? Porque el trabajo es el trabajo, ¿verdad? Entonces, pero aquí estoy oyendo con los dos.
All right. No, I don't have the phone in here porque se me apagó ahorita hace rato. That's why I haven't heard anything. But
sí, es que ahí hace un ratito entré desde que entré le puse ahí que estaba en una reunión porque como acabamos de terminar mes, entonces estamos haciendo unas proyecciones para este mes.
Acá. Uh-huh. Not projection, you're right in here. Okay. All right. Go on with
it. Ah, no, si vieran los comentarios ahí que me han puesto a mí, o sea.
Yes, I mean, just love me comments.
Clientes. Yes. Este, pero.
La aman. Ahí,
sí. Gracias a Dios. Sí, porque. Yes. Pero aquí estoy. Pero okay. No le he puesto atención al ejemplo, ni así, sinceramente. Pero aquí estoy.
Right. Okay, there you go, okay. No problem.
Okay.
All right, let's continue, people. So we got some extra examples in here, okay? Let's start reading them. Let me check the contracted example. Eric, help me out reading. Eric, this is just the structure. That was not is with wasn't, were not, weren't. Read the first example, Eric. And then Ever is gonna help me.
I wasn't an employee in that company.
Okay, good. Ever? Let's read the second one.
You weren't in the store yesterday.
Okay, good. Maritza, let's read the next one.
He wasn't in the park last week.
Okay, perfect. William, help me out with this one.
The last.
Yes, the last one.
We weren't excited about the trip.
Ah, okay, very good. They weren't excited about the trip. There you go. Now listen, listen. I'm gonna stop a little bit in here and I'm gonna move and I'm gonna pass the attendance list and then we can continue with this. Okay, just give me a couple of minutes. Because I didn't check and it was 9:13. So it's time to pass the attendance list. Let's see, Ana Claribel, you see here. Ana Claribel, are you there?
Present.
Ah, okay. I didn't even see the time that you entered. Ana Maria, yeah, she's there.
Present.
Carlos,
present, present.
Okay. Carlos Ademir. All right, Carlos didn't get connected today. Eric Guillermo.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Ever de Jesus.
Present.
Nice. Fatima Alejandra.
Present.
Okay, nice. Hilmar Cruz.
Present.
Okay. Jonathan Alexander. Jonathan. Is it Jonathan there? I think it's the one that is not connected. Jorge Elvir.
Present.
Okay. Carla Benacer.
Present, teacher.
Okay, nice. Margot Hernandez. Margot, are you there? Okay. Let's see what's up like right after the last one. Maritza Alcira.
I'm here, teacher.
Okay, good. Natalie Vanessa. Natalie didn't get connected today. Romeo Alexis.
Present.
Okay, good. Rosa del Carmen.
Present.
Okay, perfect. Ruth Joanna.
Present, teacher.
Nice. Let's see, Sara Carolina. Sara didn't get connected today. Okay. Stephanie Lisette.
Present.
Okay. Vanessa Odette.
Present.
All right. William Alberto.
Present.
Okay. Roxana Yesenia.
Present, teacher.
Okay, good. Nubia Zulema.
Present, teacher.
All right. Jennifer Noemi. No, Jennifer is not here. And Diana Gabriela.
Present, teacher.
Present. Okay. All right, good. So let's move on with the X examples that we got in here, right? So if you were taking notes about them, just let's do it, okay? Jesus Christ. Okay, I don't know if you're taking notes of them or may I continue? Ah, you see, it is working, Eric. It is doing the effect, está haciendo efecto. Ya está entrando it is covering your head with that, like, being possessed.
No, ando bien estresado.
¿Entiendes?
¿Sabe que por que un compañero resultó ahora con COVID?
Yes.
Me tocó irme a hacer las pruebas a mediodía, ¿no?
¿Again? ¿Otra vez?
Sí, pero... negativo, gracias a Dios.
Oh, it's a negative. That's pretty cool. Yeah. That's pretty nice.
Ha sido un día tenso, entonces el golpe lo recibe el cuello y los hombros. Entonces hay que estar haciendo mico y perico, como dice.
Yeah, man, in my case, it's likely the same as you, but it's this part. This part, all the way down to the neck. and then to the back. Ah, I hate that. I really
same case.
Yeah. But anyways. Okay, let's continue. I think you're not taking notes. Oh, you have already finished? No. Taking apart, we're gonna take apart the uses of the verb be. And now we're gonna start with the simple past negative statements. Ahora bien, esta ya es otra estructura completamente diferente. ¿Por qué? Vamos a dejar de lado las formas del verbo to be, okay? And right now we're gonna focus in the simple past of, you know, normal verbs. Y ahora pues vamos a hablar un poco sobre el pasado simple de los verbos normales. Acá, recordemos, no llevan la forma del verbo to be, okay? They are just normal verbs, okay? And let's start a little bit with the structure. Check this out, with the structure. And what is the most common structure? If you remember, the affirmative statements that we were practicing last class, it was, for example, I ate pizza today morning. Comí pizza este día por la mañana. Check this out. This is an affirmative statement, okay? Or positive statement. Now, what happened with negative statements? It's pretty different. Why different? Because the structure says, the structure in negative says that you use subject plus did plus not plus main verb o verbo principal plus, pero en este caso el verbo principal in base form plus complement. Esta es la estructura de una oración negativa en forma pasada simple, ¿ok? Si en la forma afirmativa nosotros decimos I ate pizza today morning, check this out, la forma base del verbo ate que tenemos ahí, recordemos, es el verbo eat, ¿ok? Que significa comer.
I ate it.
Exactly. In that case, I must say, I did not eat pizza today morning. Ok, esta es la forma formal de poder hacer esta estructura en negativo. All right, I did not eat pizza today morning. Ok, ¿por qué colocamos eat, no ate? Ah, easy.
El verbo a su forma.
Exactly, porque tenemos el verbo auxiliar do en forma pasada, que es did. Entonces, por eso, ya no es necesario que el verbo eat vaya sí. en forma pasada. Exactly, right? So, we got the contracted form. Tenemos la forma contractada. Negative statement.
I did it.
All right, there you go. I didn't eat pizza today morning. So check this out. We got that negative statement, okay? In a contracted form. That one, remember, is informal. I'm gonna put in parentheses in here. Formal, okay? Formal statement. And this one is informal. Okay? This one is informal. So this kind of a structure is easy in comparison to simple present. Why is easy or easier in this case? Because you don't have to pay attention in third person. Because in third person, remember, in simple present, we need to change the verb. In simple present, remember, do and does, okay? In simple past, it's only did for all the subjects, or all the pronouns is just did. Example. This one is in third person. Affirmative statement. In an affirmative statement, I can say, let's use a proper noun. Fatima sent, okay, a text message. Listen up. Fatima sent a text message. El verbo sent que tenemos ahí es la forma pasada del verbo send. Let's remember, okay? Enviar. Okay, now, how is the negative statement? Ah, entonces, ¿cómo es la forma negativa? Fatima did not send, okay, send. Ahora sí, colocamos el verbo en forma base. O el verbo en presentes, como ustedes lo quieran llamar. Fatima did not send a text message. You see? And we got it in simple past, very formal. Just remember, formal. Let's say formal. Okay. Now, using contractions. Fatima didn't send a text message. Okay, this one is in a somehow informal. Okay, we got it this way. There you go. And we got it that way. So, si ven ahí, el auxiliar did no cambia a pesar de que es tercera persona, right? It doesn't change. It remains the same for all the subjects, including pronouns, proper nouns, whatever you want to put in there, okay? And the base form of the verb, of course, doesn't change too. Y la forma base del verbo principal que indica la acción también. It remains the same. Permanece intacta. Okay? We don't have to make any change in that case, right? Good. Do we understand this part, people? Ahora bien, ¿entendemos esta parte? ¿Me di a entender? Oh, do you have any question? Because if you have any question, it's the time for you to ask. Okay?
Me costó un poco entender. Si lo puede volver a explicar, por favor.
Ah, okay. There you go. Listen, listen. In simple past, when we don't use the verb be, we need the auxiliary verb do. Okay, do is the base form, okay, of that auxiliary verb. In simple past of do is did. So did becomes in an auxiliary verb, okay, to create negative examples in the past, okay, or negative actions in the past. Did is used with negative statements and questions. Okay, but in this case, we are just focusing in negative statements. That's why we got did. The structure is this one. Check this out. We need a subject, the one that we got here, a subject. Remember, a subject can be any pronoun, any proper noun, okay? Any name of an animal, a name of a place, whatever. That's a subject. Right after the subject, we have to use did right after the subject. Justo después del pronombre o sujeto que tengamos ahí, or her, we need the auxiliary verb did. Necesitamos el verbo auxiliar did. Okay? Why? Because it is representing the past version of the structure. Right after did, what do we need? Ah, we need the word not. The one who is creating the negative part, okay? And right after not, we need the main verb, okay? El verbo principal, but in this case, in base form, en forma base, okay? ¿Por qué en forma base? Porque ya no necesitamos poner el verbo en pasado. ¿Por qué? Porque el verbo auxiliar ya está en pasado.
Auxiliar.
Okay, yeah, it is acting in simple past. Ya no podemos llevar los dos verbos en pasado, ¿ok? Just the auxiliary verb. And then the complement. ¿Para qué nos sirve el complemento? Just to make the, you know, like, the example more specific. That's why we have here. Check this out. In an affirmative statement, en una oración afirmativa tenemos, I ate pizza today morning. ¿Por qué tenemos ate? Porque acá en afirmación no llevamos ningún auxiliar. Y por consiguiente, el verbo está obligado a colocarse en pasado. ¿Ok? The verb, the main verb that indicates the action has to be in simple past. ¿Ok? In negative statement, since we use the auxiliary verb did plus not, so in that case, the main verb, it has to remain in simple present or base form. Okay? Or the contracted way. Did not, didn't. And then we got the verb it, the same, right? In base form. That's why in this case we say, I didn't eat pizza today morning. It's like, no comí pizza este día por la mañana o ahora por la mañana. Okay? It's likely the same in here, interperson. Interperson happens the same. Check this out. Is the same verb in simple past, the verb send, okay? But in simple past negative, we need the did version and not, and then we have to write down the main verb in base form, okay? Which is send. Send is the simple present version of the verb sent, okay? And then we said, Fatima did not, okay? Hasta acá tenemos Fatima no, and then we got send, no envió, okay? A text message, o mensaje de texto, you see? Y acá simplemente es la forma contractada, o la manera informal. Fatima didn't send a text message. Fatima no envió un mensaje de texto. Check this out. Entonces, ¿qué sucede acá? Tanto en primera persona, tercera y en plural, no cambia. Siempre es did, siempre después de did es not, y luego el verbo en forma base. ¿Okay? ¿Qué es lo único que va a cambiar? The subject. El verbo, el pronombre y el complemento. Depending on what you want to say, dependiendo de lo que quiere decir o de la acción que vamos a hablar. ¿Ok?
Ok, gracias.
All right, there you go. We can do an extra example. Or let's put the examples I got it in here, right? So check this out. I'm gonna erase this part. And let's see the examples that we got in here. Check this out. In here we got different example with different verbs. Vanessa, help me out reading the first line and then the contracted line.
Okay. I did not work yesterday. Uh-huh. I didn't work yesterday.
Okay, thank you. So take a look at that. I did not work yesterday. That's the formal version. And I didn't work yesterday. That's the contracted or informal version. You see? But they remains the same. I mean, they means the same. Significan lo mismo, right? Diana, help me out reading the second pair of examples.
You did not go to the party.
Mm-hmm.
You didn't go to the party.
Ah, to the party. Okay. There you go. Thank you, Diana. Fatima, help me out reading the third example.
He will not send emails.
Mm-hmm.
And he didn't send emails.
Okay. Thank you. Ana Garcia, let's read the next one.
We did not play soccer.
Okay.
We didn't play soccer.
Okay, very good. We did not play soccer, or we didn't play soccer. There you go. Romeo, help me on reading the next example. Romeo?
Okay. You did not feel happy. You didn't feel happy.
Okay, very good. Thank you. And let me see, we can read the last one. Let's see, Stephanie, let's read the next one, the last one.
El último.
Yes.
They did not go to the study.
They did not go to study. Uh-huh.
And they didn't go to the study.
Ah, okay. Thank you. They did not go to study. All right. And they didn't go to study. That's the contracted version. Okay, good. Right up to now, do you have people any question? Do you have any question with this? ¿Tenemos alguna pregunta? Something that might not be clear for you with this structure? ¿Algo que no esté del todo claro con esta estructura?
Al contestar así es cuando nos preguntan con el did.
En este caso, William, todas son oraciones negativas. Y si no me equivoco, el próximo lunes veríamos preguntas. Acá simplemente es cuando estamos negando algo, pero no en preguntas, sino que en una oración negativa normal. Exactly.
Okay.
Yes. This is just negatives. Ajá, y aquí estamos simplemente presentando las dos versiones. The formal one that is not contracted and the one that is contracted. Y la que está contractada. Yeah.
Okay.
Ya llegó. Acá sí podemos usar cualquier verbo. Okay. In this one, you can use any verb you want. And there's no problem.
Okay. Y la diferencia entre el pasado cuando uno dice I watched en pasado en, y este I did.
Okay.
I did not watch.
Okay. Con el verbo watch, right? Watch.
Yes.
Okay, check this out. Example. I watch this one, right? ¿A este es el que se refiere?
Yes.
I watched TV last night. Check this out. This verb, este verbo, la pronunciación de este verbo is this way. Es básicamente de esta manera, William. Watched. Listen, watched. La pronunciación, a pesar que la escritura termina en ed, la pronunciación en pasado termina con una t. El sonido de una T. Watched. With T. Watched. Okay. There you go. And what happened when we put it into a negative statement? Cuando ya la ponemos en una oración negativa, ya actúa en forma normal. Check this out. I didn't watch TV last night. What happened in this case? Ah, entonces acá, en una forma negativa, ya el verbo va en presente o forma base. ¿Por qué? Porque ya llevamos el auxiliar acá en pasado. Didn't. Entonces acá es watch. Termina en ese ch, sonido de ch, de la ch, right? Es decir, watch. Y el otro es watch. Watched. Con t al final. Watched.
Okay.
Yes. A pesar que los verbos regulares, la mayoría en escritura son sencillos porque terminan en ed, la gran mayoría de ellos, en lo que sí hay que tener cuidado siempre es en la pronunciación, porque algunos de ellos terminan en sonido de t, algunos de ellos terminan en sonido ed. Por ejemplo, el verbo want, this way, give me a second. I'm gonna write it here. Want, en pasado es wanted. Tiene dos maneras de pronunciarse. Una es wanted o la otra es wanted, wanted, sin pronunciar la T, wanted o wanted. Wanted is mostly used in British English. Es más usado en el inglés británico, wanted, right? Wanted es más usado en el, you know, like American English. Okay.
Okay. That's clear. Thank
okay. you. Good. You're welcome. There you go. Any other question, people? ¿Alguna otra pregunta? Something that might not be clear? ¿Algo que no esté claro, people? Okay. I guess everything is clear. There you go. What are we going to do now? I want you to open up your manuals because we're going to do some exercises in there. We're going to finish some things that we got in there. So let's open your manuals in page 30, let me see, 31. Yeah, it's 31. This page, this one, okay. What are we going to do in here? We're gonna practice this short conversation, okay, over here. Okay, what are we going to do with this conversation? Let's read the conversation, and after reading the conversation, if you have any problem with one word or with the pronunciation, just let me know, okay? So this conversation is between Luz and Eva. That's the pronunciation of the word Eva in English, Eva, okay? So we got Luz, it says, can you tell me more about your experience? Can you tell me more about your experience? It says Eva. It wasn't so nice. It wasn't so nice because the agent, didn't give me a confirmation number. A confirmation number. He didn't even send a receipt for what I bought. A receipt for what I bought. It says Luz. Do you remember the agent's name? Do you remember the agent's name? It says Eva. No, I don't. No, I don't. Actually, I think he didn't say his name. He didn't say his name. He wasn't kind. It says Luz. My apologies for that. And what about our product? Could you use it? And it says, Eva, yes, I could. It wasn't so easy, but I called another agent again. He was so considerate. His name was Romeo. Okay. His name was Romeo. And he explained everything to me. And he explained everything to me. All right. ¿Fue eso cierto, Romeo?
No.
Okay. Good. There you go. Okay. From here, people, from this conversation, do you have any word that is unknown for you or the word that you don't know? ¿Tenemos vocabulario ahí que no comprendamos completamente? Like a word, a phrase, pronunciation, and everything. ¿O todo está claro?
The pronunciation for kidding, kidding.
Let me check.
And the part of Eva, his name, kidding.
In here?
No, no top.
And the top.
And the finally.
He wasn't kind.
Kind.
Yeah, he wasn't kind.
He's kidding. He's kind.
No, kidding es como de bromear, right? Bromear.
Okay, yes.
Right? But in this case, yes. Kind significa amable. Okay?
Kind. Okay. Kind. Okay, yes. Thank you.
There you go. Kind. Any other word that you have might be with issues?
Apologies.
Apologies? Disculpas? Yeah, it's like missing culpas. It's like when you, like, it's a very formal way to say sorry. All right. What is actually, people? Bien, ya que ustedes no preguntan, yo voy a preguntar. What is actually?
Actualmente.
No.
En el momento. ¿Eh?
Regularmente.
No.
Actualmente.
No.
Realmente.
Actually significa en realidad. Realmente. Actualmente se conoce como actualito. Currently. Ese es actualmente.
Actualito.
Currently. Actualito. Actualito.
¿Qué dice que significa, teacher?
En realidad. Este es el que ustedes llaman actualmente. Currently. Así se escribe actualmente. Currently. Ok.
Is synonymous the real?
Exactly.
Ok.
Ok, good. There we go. So we got that part from the conversation. Ok. And let me check. Yeah. Read the conversation again, it says, and write the activities that happened and the ones that didn't. Okay, let's do this part. Listen, let's do this one. And I think in 5 minutes we can do this. What are we gonna do with this information? Check this out. We're gonna do, or we're gonna write in here, the activities that are done in this conversation and activities that didn't happen. It says, check this out. Read the conversation again and write the activities that happened and the ones that didn't. Entonces, vamos a colocar acá las actividades que pasaron o que sucedieron en la conversación y las que no sucedieron. How come? ¿Cómo lo vamos a hacer? In there, you got the activities, right? Ahí ya tenemos el uso de los negativos, qué actividades se dieron y qué actividades no se dieron. Okay. In this case, let's write down at least two activities that happened in there and two activities that did not happen. Okay. Vamos a escribir entonces, de cierta manera acá, dos actividades, para no hacerlo muy largo, okay. Dos actividades que sucedieron y dos que no sucedieron de acuerdo a la conversación. Okay. That's all we're going to be doing. And let's try to do it in pairs. Let me see. Just to confirm. Yeah, I mean, everybody is in here. Except, let me see. Margot, are you there? Because I need to check if she's there. Margot, are you there? All right, she's not there. Okay, what are we gonna do? Los voy a mandar a trabajar en parejas para que me hagan eso. Quiero dos actividades que sí sucedieron en la conversación. Recuerden, en las actividades que sí se dieron, no me van a escribir negativos. En la forma o las actividades que no se dieron, ahí sí me van a escribir las formas negativas en, okay? En pasado, tal y como están en la conversación. Ok, there you go. Just give me a second, I'm going to stop sharing for a moment, and I'm going to send you to work. So we are 18:17. Okay, give me a second, I'm going to put it this way. All right. Okay, good. Let's go for it, okay? Let's answer that activity. We're gonna do it that for 5 minutes and then we're gonna come back. Luego vamos a volver después de 5 minutos. Let's work in pairs and do that and then we come back. Let's get accepted. Démosle aceptar, por favor. All right, there we go. Diana, démosle aceptar. I'm gonna make a change.
Hoy sí le escucho.
Ah, hi. Sí. I had to change you, Maritza, porque una de las participantes aparentemente y solo está conectada, pero no me contestó, así que no pudo entrar. Así que tuve que mandarlo porque Ana estaba sola. Okay.
Va a estar bien.
There you go. So, what are we going to do? Let's remember. Dos actividades que sí sucedieron en la conversación y dos que no. Las que no me las van a colocar con, ya sea con la forma del verbo to be en pasado, en negativo y o con did, not, en okay. Este caso sería didn't, okay? Ok, let's write down just two of them. All right, very good.
Gracias.
I wasn't
como la otra, el otro agente sí fue considerado o amable, esa parte sí creo, no sé si eso podríamos usar en en la parte donde las cosas que se hicieron.
No so entiendo. Nice, because the agent did not, no lo confirmó, dice. No, no le dio la confirmación del
el número de confirmación, ajá.
Ajá, no se lo dio.
Pero esas son las cosas que no se hicieron.
Ajá.
Teacher, que... ayuda.
Ajá, con eso. Ajá.
Porque, o sea, yo sí veo bastantes actividades como que sí, no se hicieron, pero... Por ejemplo, la confirmación, que la gente no fue amable, he was in King. Pero lo que se hizo no entiendo esa parte.
Por ejemplo, she called another agent. Llamó a otro agente. ¿Eso se dio?
Sí, sí.
You see?
Okay.
Okay. Good.
Sí.
Bien. Bueno, si necesitan ayuda or something else, just request it, okay? Voy a ver otro breakout room porque me están pidiendo ayuda. Okay, good. Hello?
Teacher.
Ajá, tell me.
Mencionó que teníamos que sacar dos actividades. No sé si entendí mal.
Sí, por lo menos dos actividades que sí se dieron en la conversación. Menciona actividades que pasaron y las que no pasaron. Entonces, eso es lo que vamos a colocar en los cuadros que están ahí. Si no tenemos los manuales impresos, los podemos colocar en el cuaderno. No problem, right?
Okay.
Two activities that did not happen in the conversation and activities that did happen. For example, una actividad que no sucedió fue, por ejemplo, listen, the agent didn't give Eva a confirmation number. El agente no le dio en este caso a Eva, un número de confirmación. Entonces, es algo que no sucedió. That can be one. Do you both have the manual? ¿Ambos tienen el manual?
No. Yo tengo una captura. Bueno, lo tengo en digital.
Ajá. And you, William?
Yes.
All right. Perfect. Okay, perfect. Perfect. Muy bien, en ese caso. Entonces, ahí lo que pueden hacer es compartirse las actividades o discutir cuál puede ser la posible actividad que se vio, cuál no. All right. Just write it down there.
Okay. Thank you, perfect. Teacher.
Okay, you're welcome. Lesson number three.
Oh, no sé cómo es que lo pronuncio.
Okay.
My apologize for that. And what about product? Could you use it?
Yes, I could. It's wasn't so easy, but I calling another agent again. It was so considerate. His name was Romeo. And he explaining everything to me.
Okay.
Again. Pasamos a la otra parte. Hey, teacher, hello.
Hi.
La última vez pasamos.
Okay.
Perfect. ¿Cómo vamos con las actividades? The did and didn't.
This moment practice the conversation and is the last time and next step complement the exercise.
Okay, all right, very good. Let's practice one more time and then in the deep part write the activities that were given, okay, like positive ones, and then didn't the activities that they were not given. Okay, in the conversation.
Okay, only one question, teacher.
Uh-huh.
For example, in the activity three, didn't. For example, for us is the agent didn't giving me a confirmation number.
Okay, very good. Ese es uno. Solo que en ese caso, en vez de poner me, va a colocar Eva, porque a esa persona fue.
Okay. Oh.
The agent didn't give Eva a confirmation number.
Ah, okay. Replace this, me for Eva. Okay.
Exactly.
Okay, perfect. Thank you.
All right, very good.
One more time.
Okay.
I say, Romeo.
Explain.
Everything to me.
En ese caso, como es una oración positiva, no vamos a colocar did. Solo explained con ed, porque ese es el verbo en pasado. Explicó.
Okay. Uh-huh.
solo en las negativas es que usaríamos did y el not.
Ah, ok. Uh-huh. Okay.
Yes. Pero en las positivas, entonces... en las positivas solo va a ir el verbo en pasado, ok. Dependiendo si es regular o irregular. En este caso, explained es el verbo regular, se le escribe ed al final.
Ah, entonces en la columna que dice did, solo vamos a poner Romeo explained.
Positivas, oraciones positivas, como las que estábamos practicando ayer.
Ok.
Uh-huh. Okay. Now, por ejemplo,
sería con el was.
No, ahí depende, no. Depende de la acción, depende de lo que está hablando, ¿ok? Así puede usar was, o puede usar were, o puede usar cualquiera de los verbos anteriores, ¿ok? Por ejemplo, en una actividad que se haya dado, vamos a ver, let me see. Do you remember? No, I didn't actually. I didn't mention his name. He was in time. Apologies for that. Lo que usted puede poner ahí es que. Let me check about your phone. It's like cool. All right. Eva could use the product. I'm going to write it down in the chat. Esa es una actividad que se dio.
Ajá.
Eva,
what? The product. This one. Ahí se los acaban de enviar al chat. Eva pudo usar el producto. Esa es una actividad que sí se dio, que ahí menciona. Uh-huh. ¿Y por qué Eva y no I? Porque como estamos hablando de que ella lo hizo y ella está hablando en primera persona, entonces no podemos poner I, sino que el nombre, en este caso, de la persona.
Ok.
Teacher, entonces, en la de didn't,
va a ser... una que no se dio, va, por ejemplo, una actividad que no se dio ahí, dice, he didn't even send a receipt, o the agent, en este caso, the agent didn't give Eva a confirmation number. The agent didn't give Eva a confirmation number. Ahí aparece como, the agent didn't give me a confirmation number. Pero en ese caso, en vez de me, va a colocar el nombre de Eva.
Yeah, okay.
Exactly. There you go.
Donde vea. Donde dice que no le dio el nombre, estaría bien si le ponemos he didn't say his name.
Yes.
Okay.
Very good. Bien, vamos a dar 2 minutos para ver si se puede complementar, ok. Then we're gonna come back. Luego vamos a regresar.
Okay, thank you.
There you go.
Okay.
Roxana, why are you alone? ¿Por qué estás sola?
Hello, teacher. Se desconectó Ruth. Teacher, pero tengo... Se desconectó Ruth. Teacher, pero tengo una duda. En las actividades que no se dieron, por ejemplo, es que no adquirió experiencia.
Yes, yes. La otra puede ser que the agent didn't give Eva the confirmation number. Ahí dice, the agent didn't give, en este caso tiene me, pero ese me lo puede eliminar y poner el nombre de Eva. The agent didn't give Eva the confirmation number.
Sería the didn't give Eva a confirmation number. Esa yes. Sería la otra negativa, ¿verdad?
Yes. Yes. You know what? La voy a enviar a otro para que pueda estar en conversación con un compañero porque you're alone here. Usted está sola acá.
Está bien, teacher.
Gonna send you to room 4. Okay. Hello. Hello, Charro, do you finish?
Charro, que nos cayó la ley.
Yes, man.
Hey, teacher, I, Romeo has a problem.
Which problem has Romeo in that case?
In the group, the WhatsApp.
The WhatsApp group? What happened?
Estoy en otro grupo. Pero es que la vez pasada andaba buscando usted y perdido.
What? Why? Sí. I mean, why are you in another group?
Ahorita están mandando toda la satisfacción de encuesta.
What?
Sí.
No, no, no. Sálgase de ese grupo y ahorita mismo le voy a enviar. Es que no, hombre, Romeo, usted no platica, usted no dice nada.
No, como yo me uní a ese grupo, pensé que...
My God, Romeo.
¿Qué pasó, Romeo?
Lo que pasa es que
vio que en el otro grupo estaban más interesantes las chicas que las de este grupo.
Ok. No, hombre, Romeo, sálgase de ese grupo y ahorita mismo voy a enviar... Ahí está. Este es el enlace para abrir WhatsApp y poderse unir al grupo. Lo he enviado varias veces, Romeo, ¿me extraña?
No, pero es que... como el segundo día, creo.
Ok. Nah,
hay que acordar que hicieron un gran relajo con los grupos.
Yeah, I mean, that's true. No, but leave that group, Romeo, and join to this one. Ok.
Ahí me acabo de ir ya.
Ok.
Le digo a Eric que lo andaba buscando, creo que el miércoles lo andaba buscando y cree que lo encontraba.
My God, Romeo.
Se perdió el teacher.
Not possible, Romeo, not possible. There you go. But do you finish?
Yes, teacher.
Ok, nice. Let me check. I'll be checking Arlen Rosa.
All right. Así lo hemos realizado.
All right. Perfect. Bien, entonces solo voy a revisar un grupo más, which is Carla and Rosa. And then we're going to go back to the main session, okay?
Okay, teacher.
Good.
Not so easy, but I called another agent again. He was so considerate. His name was Romeo, and he explained everything to me.
Hi.
Hi, teacher.
Hi.
¿Terminaron la actividad?
Yes.
Okay, perfect.
Yeah.
All right, nice. Bien, entonces ustedes eran prácticamente el último grupo que me quedaba, a mí, la pareja que me quedaba por, you know, like, check. All right, then we can finish this part. Bien, les espero entonces en la sección principal, okay?
Yo dije, ya nos olvidó, nos dejó ahí aventadas, dije yo.
No, why not? I mean, I told you, we're gonna go back and run again. All right, there you go. More and more people are coming. Hey, what happened to the rest?
Pues sí, más que se tardan en la platicada que deben de estar, hombre.
Ya fueron a dormir, teacher.
Not actually. Lo que pasa es que algunos no dejan que el sistema los lance de nuevo para acá y no se unen rápido. Ah, you see? Yeah, I mean, that's what happened. But they are getting connected right now. Yeah, yes, they are. All right, let's see. Okay, we got it there. Bien. Bien, Romeo. Para la próxima, Romeo, revisemos bien, okay? Let's check.
Me perdido.
Porque, I mean, hemos estado compartiendo mucho en el grupo y usted por otro lado, no, hombre. Tampoco así. Okay. All right, people, listen. Because of the time, por motivos de tiempo, and because I know, I mean, I'm taking like 10 more minutes right after your regular time, this activity lo vamos a tomar de modo feedback el próximo lunes, ¿ok? Las respuestas de estas actividades, de esta actividad que ustedes me han hecho, ¿ok? La completamos, I guess everybody completed, right? Entonces el lunes, al principio de la clase, vamos a revisar sus respuestas, ¿ok? Like a model of feedback. And the only thing I got for you is, listen, during this weekend, I don't know if you finished, if you did the discussion section that I sent it to the group today. All right, if you didn't, si no lo hicieron, tienen este fin de semana para hacerlo. Ahora voy a postear otro, okay? What happened there? Simplemente son
vamos oraciones. A fin de semana, teacher.
Simplemente, yeah, man, like you got free. No, pero no son oraciones, I mean, like super complicated. No creo, Ana María, que no tenga 3 minutos, like, to do that. I mean, that's no. So simple. Ah, no, pues entonces. No, listen. Simplemente lo que les he pedido ahí son como 4 oraciones, creo. Okay. Entonces, para este tema, igual, con el uso de los negativos, voy a postear ahí que me dan un par de ejemplos, ¿ok? Lo que tienen que hacer es solo irse a la parte de la discussion section y luego, pues, poderlo hacer. Tienen el fin de semana para poderlo hacer, ¿ok? Just on Monday, like, just to start up with a new video conference. Bien, entonces, así lo vamos a hacer. Voy a pasar asistencia y nos vamos a quedar hasta acá, ¿ok? The checking of the activity, we're going to do it on Monday. Give me a second. I'm going to pass the attendance list, and that's going to be everything for tonight. Let's start up. Ana Claribel?
Present.
Okay, good. Ana Maria?
Present.
Okay, good. Carlos Ademir is not here. Eric Guillermo?
Present, sure.
Okay, nice. Ever de Jesus? Ever? Hey, what happened to Ever? Okay.
Let's se quedó en el break.
Está cubriendo Jennifer.
Ah, okay. Ajá.
Fátima se quedó en el break.
Fátima Alejandra.
Present, teacher.
Ah, okay. Good. Let's see. Hilmar Cruz.
Present.
Good. Joan, Jonathan Alexander. I mean, Jonathan got problems. Yeah, now I remember. Jorge Elvir.
Present.
Okay, good. Then we got Carla Benazir.
Present, teacher.
Good. Margot didn't answer. Maritza Alcira.
I'm here, teacher.
Okay, good. Maritza? You're going to have the 10 minutes feedback tonight, okay? Let's stay with me right after the class.
Otra vez, teacher.
What's with you?
Cambiamos el miércoles porque alguien no iba a estar.
Let me check.
Y what, ayer le tocaba.
Ayer me tocó a mí, teacher.
But yesterday was with Carla, yeah. Let's see, Maritza.
And la noche anterior nos quedamos.
I was with, but in this case, Natalie didn't show up. Romeo. Okay, Romeo, we're gonna stay there, okay? Está.
Otra vez que vi.
Deja de
poncharme.
No, I mean, that's giving extra feedback, not poncharla. Okay, good. So I'm gonna do it with Romeo then. So, because Natalie is not here, right? Okay, Romeo Alexis. Here. Are you there, Romeo?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, good. Rosa del Carmen.
Present.
All right. Ruth Joanna.
Present, teacher.
Okay, good. Sara Carolina is not here. Stephanie Lisette.
Present.
Okay, nice. Vanessa Odette. Where is Anna? No, no sé, I think she got away. William Alberto.
Present.
Ah, okay. Thank you, William. Roxana Yesenia.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Nubia Zulema. Nubia.
Present, teacher.
Okay. So Jennifer didn't show up. And Diana Gabriela, she's the last one.
Present.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, hoy sí todavía no se ha dormido.
Okay. No.
All right, there you go. Okay, say hi to your daughter. All right, people. I hope you have a wonderful weekend. All right, let's have fun and see you on Monday, okay? Bye-bye.
Bye.
Good
night.
Night,
happy weekend, everybody.
All right, let's have a happy weekend. Bye-bye. There you go. Romeo, no se me vaya a ir.
Have a good night.
Okay, bye-bye.
Happy six pack, teacher.
Yummy. Happy Child's Day.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, man, yes.
Good night.
Good night. Bye-bye. Okay, let me check in here. So what's up with these people? My God. All right, Romeo, turn on the camera. We're gonna talk seriously. But okay. First, all right. Is it Nubia there? Nubia, are you there? Nubia. Ah, no, she's not there. I thought she was there. Okay, Romeo, we're going to have 10 minutes just to clarify any question or any idea that you might have related to the class, okay? So, do you have any question, Romeo, related to the class? Or the previous class? Which one? ¿Cuál?
Con where? Cuando usar which, con where, más que todo con where, porque ahí me quedé algo dudoso.
¿Esta parte? Where?
Ajá. ¿Cuándo vamos a hacer wash, where, y para expresar algo en la oración?
Ok, where, listen, where se utiliza con you, we, they, and plural nouns, nombres plurales. ¿Cómo así? Yo puedo decir Romeo and Fátima. Romeo y Fátima. En este caso acá estoy mencionando a dos personas. That's plural. ¿Ok? Entonces acá podemos crear oraciones, ¿ok? Ya sea positivas o negativas. Let's put an affirmative statement. Take this out. Let's say Romeo and Fatima were in the park. Romeo y Fatima estaban en el parque. Okay.
Ahora bien. El where, el que estamos viendo ahora.
Yes. Este es positivo. Este lo vimos ayer. Ok. Nada más lo estoy haciendo así para que entendamos de mejor manera cuál es la posición de la palabra not para formar el negativo. Ahora bien. Negative statement. Oración negativa. Check this out. Romeo and Fatima were not in the park. No estaban en el parque. Y lo podemos hacer de la manera más informal. How come? ¿Cómo así? Mira acá. Romeo and Fátima weren't. Y aquí es la manera contractada. Weren't es la manera contractada de were y not. In the park. Romeo and Fatima weren't in the park. ah, Romeo y Fátima no estaban en el parque. Entonces acá ya estamos denotando un plural. Estamos hablando del plural. Ahora bien, otra. You were not in the party. Okay, we weren't in the class. Ah, no estuvimos en la clase. No estuviste en la fiesta. They weren't busy. Ah, no estuvieron ocupados. Ellos no estuvieron ocupados. Recordemos que el verbo were, parte del verbo to be, es básicamente la forma pasada del verbo are, de la forma are. Okay. Entonces acá es para denotar, más que todo para hablar en plurales o de una segunda persona, como en el primer ejemplo que tenemos ahí. You were not in the party. Tú no estuviste en la fiesta. Recordemos que en este caso puede expresar ser o estar, pero en pasado, ¿ok? Uh-huh. Ser o estar en pasado.
Y a diferencia de lo que estaba mencionando ayer, sería positivo. Ayer yes. era positivo.
Ayer era positivo. Por ejemplo, acá. Esto era parte de lo de ayer, mire. Porque no llevo not. Romeo y Fátima were in the park. Ahora bien, el tema de ahora. Negative statements. Romeo y Fátima were not in the park. ¿Qué es lo único que se le agrega acá? El not, la palabra not. ¿Ok? La palabra not. Ah, si yo esta oración que tengo acá, you were not in the party, la tuviese positiva, entonces sería, mire, you were in the party. Ah, estuviste en la fiesta. You see? Estuviste en la fiesta. That's the way. Entonces, esa es la forma en cómo se maneja. Entonces, podemos usarla con adjetivos. Por ejemplo, busy es un adjetivo que describe. Entonces, busy significa ocupado. They weren't busy. Ellos no estuvieron ocupados. Nosotros no estuvimos en clase. ¿Ok? Eso significa esa parte. Y acá, you were not in the party. Tú no estuviste en la fiesta. ¿Ok? Y esta es la positiva. Estuviste en la fiesta. Esta es parte de lo que estuvimos hablando ayer. Oraciones positivas.
En este caso son oraciones, digamos, y se pueden usar el were y el...
¿Y el was?
En forma de pregunta.
Sí se pueden utilizar, y si no me equivoco, creo que esa forma, Romeo, la vamos a ver el próximo... Eso lo vamos a ver el próximo lunes, Romeo. Las formas de pregunta. Vaya, ayer vimos las formas positivas, oraciones positivas, ¿ok? Ahora vimos las oraciones negativas. El lunes vamos a hacer preguntas con estas estructuras. Ajá. Entonces, hasta el lunes vamos a poder hablar sobre las formas de pregunta. Para así no confundirnos. Porque acá simplemente es cuando usted está hablando en negativo. Cuando usted no estuvo en un lugar, cuando usted no hizo algo, ¿ok? O cuando usted habla de algo que no sucedió. ¿Ok? Algo que realmente no sucedió.
Okay.
Bien. Entonces, no sé si estamos claros con el uso de where y en negativo.
Sí, lo otro que le quería preguntar era conforme al verbo, el be es lo que me estaba aclarando ahorita, ¿verdad?
Sí, esta es una forma del verbo be. Uh-huh. Vaya, el verbo be en pasado solamente son dos maneras. Be en pasado se deriva en was y también en were. Estas sí, dos son las formas del verbo be.
Ya, ahí me aclaré esa parte. Y ahí lo otro. Bueno, pero eso, lo de las oraciones del martes. Sí, los temas del martes, lunes y martes ya. ¿Qué darían para?
Questions. ¿Cuáles?
Google. Y mine.
Ah, would y might. Might. Ambas son para mostrar posibilidad a futuro o puede ser a presente. Ok. I will, listen up, I will buy a new car. Es como compraría un nuevo carro. Ok. Y might viene siendo lo mismo. I might buy a new car. Ambas oraciones en este caso, Romeo, significan lo mismo. Compraría un carro nuevo. Ok. Entonces, ¿para qué usamos will y might? Ah, sí, sí. La mayoría de veces la usamos para possibility. Right. Let's put it this way, para que no se me equivoque más. Possibility. La usamos para expresar posibilidades. Okay. That's the way. For possibilities. Y también para formal requests. Ah, y para peticiones o solicitudes formales. Ah, pero eso es cuando ya es pregunta. Would you, listen, would you work extra hours? ¿Trabajarías horas extras? Right? Yes, I will work extra hours. Esa es la respuesta. O si es negativa, no, I wouldn't work extra hours. Would you work extra hours? ¿Trabajarías horas extras? Yes, I will work extra hours. Sí, trabajaría horas extras. No, I wouldn't work extra hours. No, no trabajaría horas extras. Entonces, ¿qué estamos expresando acá? Acá estamos haciendo una formal request. ¿Ok? Una solicitud formal. Ah, es como que su jefe Romeo le dijera, hey Romeo, would you work extra hours? ¿Trabajaría horas extras? ¿Ok? ¿Qué está haciendo ahí? Como una especie de petición formal. ¿Ok? For you to do that.
Fíjense que ese día creo que me conecté tarde, entonces no alcancé a copiar la estructura.
Ok. La estructura básicamente de el verbo to be que estuvimos viendo, la forma del verbo be, es más o menos así. Tenemos subject plus be plus not plus complement. Así. Esta es la estructura. Esta es la estructura. Vamos a escribir un ejemplo. Mire. I was not in the store. Y vamos a escribir una con where. You were not happy. Vaya. I, en este caso, es el sujeto, el subject. Be es representado por was. Not, tenemos la forma de negación. In the store es básicamente el complemento. Igual acá, mire. You es el subject. Where es la otra forma del verbo be. Not en la forma simplemente de negación. And happy es el complemento. ¿Okay? Entonces acá mm-hmm. tiene la estructura con dos ejemplos adicionales. ¿Okay? Esta era la estructura que estábamos practicando.
Ah, ok.
Yes.
Sí.
Yes.
Sí, sí, eso es lo que tenía, teacher.
All right, perfect. Yeah, muy bien. No sé si tiene alguna otra pregunta adicional con otra estructura o vocabulary that you probably have problem with.
Lo que me estaba costando, creo que la última corrección que me hizo es en el uso de on, in y they, más que todo para anexar, digamos, en el complemento.
Ah, sí, en ese caso, recordemos, cuando mencionamos lugares, generalmente utilizamos in. In, es más que todo, por ejemplo, in the park, okay? In the city, in San Salvador, okay? On es más que todo cuando mencionamos carreteras o lugares específicos, como on the beach, on the street, on Second Avenue, okay? Entonces, ambas se pueden usar para mencionar lugares, solo que in es para mencionar, recuerde, ciudades, países, ¿ok? O espacios cerrados, in the classroom, en el salón de clase, ah, es un espacio cerrado, ¿ok? In the office, en la oficina, ah, es un espacio cerrado, por eso usamos in, ¿ok? Ya digo. Entonces, en ese caso, esos son los tipos de preposiciones que solemos usar.
Ok. Sí, que eso no. Santa Claus en la media por divino.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
Creo que solo eso, dicho.
Nah. Ah, oh, ok. There you go. Bah. Bah, perfecto, entonces, Romeo. There you go. What are we gonna do? Bien, solo quedaríamos pendientes entonces, Romeo, de la discussion section, la sección de discusión que voy a postear ahora en la plataforma. Ok. Y quedó una de la de ayer y la de ahora, que si tiene tiempo, ok. Me gustaría que lo hiciera este fin de semana para ya el lunes estar completo. Okay? Ok. Así como también la tarea 11. De la clase de ayer y la tarea 12 de esta clase, que básicamente ya para el lunes tendrían que estar finalizadas para así, ya cuando lleguemos a miércoles de nuevo y ya toque estar subiendo notas, no estar con pendientes, ¿ok?
Ok, dicho. Ya te pude preguntar.
Ok, perfecto, Romeo. Entonces, nos vemos el próximo lunes, ¿ok?
Ok,
bye bye. Ok, bye bye.